Hey, this is Kev with Blender Binge, back with another tutorial for you. This time I got another request on how I'd go about making a microscopic environment, or another one asking how I would do a scanning electron microscope shader. So without further ado, I'm going to show you how to do that in a really short video. It's easy and you'll love it and be able to do it yourself when you're done. Ready? Let's go. So my scene here is really simple. I just created this little capsule thing out of a UV sphere that I stretched out and sliced up a few times. And you see here that I have a pretty simple scene. It's just resting on a plane, nothing too crazy, and the camera's just staring at it. So if I were to kind of move around here, let me hit N, turn this off, and you can see what I'm doing. Here is my scene, simple. And what I could have done too is I could delete this light because I don't need it. Go back into my window and let's get started on creating this little guy here. So I'll turn back on lock camera to view so that I can move around and let's go. So the first thing I'll do is I will create a shader window in here. Yeah, I could use this shading tab here in 2.8, but I just like doing this because it's easy and I'm used to it and it works. So I'm going to hit this, go to shader editor, select my capsule, hit new. And now you see here that I have this principled BSDF shader plugged into material output. I could go ahead and use this, that's fine. So let's turn on Eevee and let's go ahead and take the base color of this to nothing, to black. And what I'll do now is I will also, while I'm here, turn the roughness all the way up to 1. So that way it's not reflecting anything and it's just matte black. So now I can get rid of this by just hitting this little tab here and it just turns into a big blob and I can move it out of the way. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to split shaders. So I'm going to hit Shift A, or you can go to add, doesn't matter. Shader, mix shader, and throw in a mix shader. So principled BSDF will be going into the top. And now I'm going to hit Shift A again or go to add, either one, shader, emission shader. Throw that down here and plug that into the second slot. So now this little factor thing goes between the principled shader at 0 and my emission shader at 1. But we're not going to control it with that. We're going to control it with something even cooler. So I'm going to hit Shift A again. I'm going to go to input and I'm going to hit layer weight. And I'm going to use the Fresnel effect here of this layer weight shader. I could also use facing, which is why I'm choosing this layer weight. There is a Fresnel shader in there, but just going to go ahead and plug that in. And now you can see that I'm controlling this with this blend. So the blend will push shader number 2, which is emission, out to the edges, and it'll keep the principled in the middle. So whatever the camera glances at directly, you see is dark, and as you recede to the edges and the angle gets greater, you get this light effect. So we're 90% there. Only thing left to make it look like this is to give it the bump. And I'm not going to concern myself too much with all the bending and weird shapes here. I'm just going to do it on one and then I'll duplicate it and show you, but it's simple. So for this, we're using Eevee. So I can just go into here, into modifiers. And a cool shortcut here is if I hit Control 3, that drops in a subdivision surface modifier and the view is set to 3. So I'm going to push that up to, yeah, I'll use 3 here and render 3. So that way they're both equal. And then I'm going to add modifier and I'm going to do displace. It blows it up. Don't like that. Hit new. It shrinks it down. Don't like that either. Hit this little button right here, or you could hit this little thing here, texture. Either one works. Type, image movie, change it to clouds, and I get that. Well, that's kind of cool, just in itself. Kind of dig it. But I'm going to go back here to modifier, turn the strength down to about there. And now you see we're pretty close to that. So now if I just bumped up my strength of my Fresnel shader and maybe took this down to 0.2, maybe 0.15. Okay, you're getting that look. And that's really all there is to it. So I'm going to pause the video and kind of duplicate this, and you'll see that we can get pretty close really quickly to the look of this guy right here. Okay, so I've gone ahead and spread these around, and You can see they're not like bent or anything. You know, I could do a tutorial on how I would actually bend these things and spread them around and make it all uneven and whatever. But the last thing I wanted to show you too is that you can grab each one of these and you can play with the strength or the texture coordinate, and you can start making them look just a little bit different and a little less uniform just by playing with the different shaders and the textures and things, and kind of go to town. And you know, that looks pretty cool right there. So you go have fun, play around with this stuff, and make some microscopic stuff. So hopefully you got something out of this tutorial. If you did, hit like, subscribe, share, and hit that little bell notification, because I keep making more, and I will see you in the next video. Thanks. Bye.